restaurant. Another example is that Peter loves his restaurant. Nobody, other people loves it. He loves all restaurants. So probably, it's not the restaurant that's good, but probably you would guess that it's something to do with Peter. Peter probably doesn't like to do his own dishes. Another possibility is that he only likes his restaurant for this one occasion. Normally doesn't like it, nobody else likes it. So you would guess that it's something to do with circumstances at that moment. Maybe he's at a date with a very beautiful girl, maybe just had too much to drink that day, so he's very happy and likes the restaurant. The last example shows that he likes it one time, all other people normally likes it, and he normally likes to eat out. And then it's too difficult, then we cannot see what to attribute to. It's too complicated. That's all for me.
Okay, now, following Anders, can you hear me? Following Anders' explanation of three validity, three terms of validity, I'd like to introduce you a research done in 1978 by Richard Spankman for his PhD degree. I hope this research can give you some insight about how to connect the theories you've learned to the field you are interested in. In this research, Budtz connects the attribution theory with advertisement effectiveness. That is to say, connects the social psychology field with business or communication. As you can see, the attribution theory studies how people attribute with reasons for certain kinds of context and how these kinds of perceptions influence people's behavior. Here, this research takes spokesperson's image as the context of an